In the sediment under the North Sea, there are dozens of oil and gas fields. While in the southern part there is a large basin in which there are many natural gas deposits, the north is dominated by oil fields. For extracting these fossil hydrocarbons, there are a total of almost 500 rigs in operation. The exploration of the North Sea is largely completed. As such, no new discoveries of oil or natural gas deposits are to be expected nowadays. In other parts of the world, however, the search is still in full swing. In order to find new fields, large seismic measurement campaigns, so-called acquisitions, are necessary. The measurement data that result are of high value for the prospecting company. Here I shall show you, using an example from the southern North Sea basin, how data recording from these type of marine data acquisition proceeds and how the data can be evaluated. Hello and welcome. What are the steps involved in marine seismics? And how can an evaluation produce information on the location of fossil hydrocarbons, in other words, crude oil and natural gas, in the Earth's subsurface? I will address these questions in this video and present how the basic steps of applied seismology are transferred to the marine case. On the one hand, you will learn how seismic signals at sea are created and recorded. And on the other, I shall show you, using an example in the North Sea, how seismic processing of measurement data can produce an image of the subterranean structures. In 2016, the North Sea countries extracted approximately 150 million tons of crude oil. This is equivalent to approximately 1/30 of the worldwide production at this time. At the same time, the economically recoverable quantity of oil in the North Sea is about 1,600 million tons. This proven and commercially recoverable quantity is referred to by the term raw material reserves. Alongside this, there are also estimations for the raw material resources. These consist firstly of the proven quantity, which is not economically recoverable. Added to this is the geologically potential quantity, which might be recoverable in the future, but which has not yet been proven. The raw material resources are many times higher than the existing reserves. The discovery of such geologically possible resources requires large-scale seismic acquisitions carried out on land and on water. The procedures of data recording and processing on water follows the general scheme of seismics and begins with the generation of seismic waves. Since water has no shear strength, there are no restoring forces for transverse oscillations. So in the water there are no transverse waves that would oscillate orthogonally to the direction of wave propagation. In fact, in marine acquisitions, one generates only longitudinal, that are pressure waves, which oscillate in the direction of propagation. For this purpose, airguns are used. Airguns are special acoustic sources which can be operated with compressed air underwater. In these airguns, highly compressed air is filled through a control piston into the chamber shown here below. The pressure from the top ensures that the chamber remains closed. Once the solenoid valve opens, the piston accelerates upwards and the compressed air is discharged to the outside. This generates an air pulse and, as such, the desired acoustic waves in the water. Afterwards, the bubble oscillates, because the gas pressure and the water pressure alternately prevail. This construction allows a rapid sequence of shots and signal excitations up to the kilohertz range. These high frequencies result in small wavelength, with which it is possible to investigate small-scale structures in the subsurface. The waves produced this way reach the seabed and couple as P waves into the subsurface. There, they are reflected and refracted at layer boundaries, reach the seabed again, and then the water surface, where they are recorded by special measuring devices, namely hydrophones. Unlike seismic measuring instruments on land, hydrophones measure no ground movements. Hydrophones, instead, are downstream water microphones that record pressure fluctuations. For this purpose, piezoelectric elements are typically used, which react sensitively to changes in pressure. If the piezoelectric element is compressed by the effects of pressure, this induces a voltage V recorded over a time sequence. During accelerations, on the other hand, both sides of the element bend, the distance between the surfaces remains the same and no signal is measured. Exploration vessels throw both airguns as well as multiple hydrophones attached to long cables through the sea. The airguns are located about 100 meters behind the ship's rear, while the hydrophones are pulled on often kilometer-long cables behind the ship. These long chains of hydrophones are referred to as streamers. Marine acquisitions often last several weeks and were also carried out in the past in the North Sea to prospect for the fossil hydrocarbons. In the following, I would show you an example from the southern sector of the North Sea. From large-scale geological investigations, it is known that the southern North Sea basin arose due to an expansion in the northeast-southwest direction. The result of this so-called extension were salt domes that rose and caused overlying rock layers to be raised or penetrated. Crude oil and natural gas can accumulate in bedrock on the flanks or below salt domes. The salt and other impermeable rock layers therefore served as an overlying sealant or covering layer for oil and gas. Seismic exploration in the North Sea have played a major role in seeking out such salt domes and determining their shape. After the measurement, the data acquired is processed. Here one seeks out layer boundaries that have become disrupted or bulged out by the salt. In a second step, the impact of these rock layers above the bedrock is removed so that the basis of the salt, that is the lower limit, can be evaluated. This figure shows a selection of seismograms obtained from a common midpoint or CMP grid. The numbers indicate the common midpoint along the measurement profile. With that, a wedge-shaped impression arises from the travel times of varying length. The larger the source-receiver distance, the longer the travel time and the later the arrival time in the recording. Such data is first corrected for the travel time of the perpendicular ray path. This is the NMO correction. Then the data can be stacked and a simulated zero offset profile can be acquired as a result. The profile shows the shape of a salt dome that is a bulge with relatively steep flanks. The events A to D characterize reflections along the base of the salt. They are of great interest since they can reveal the lower limit of the bedrock. In this stacked profile, visible layer boundaries are first interpreted in order to determine the propagation velocities in the individual layers. The seabed is orange and marked with H1 in this example. H6B in red represents the upper boundary of the salt. The white line, H7, is its base. In the velocity analysis, migration is carried out systematically for different velocity models. In this way, the events of the profiles are depicted at their true depth. In simple terms, the following is tried. Firstly, structures and particularly important events are focused upon, and as a result of this, the base of the salt is made easily visible. And secondly, the events for all source receiver distances shown are depicted at their correct depth. Here you can see the result for the final propagation velocity model. One can clearly see the difference between the salt and the overlying strata. With the help of this model, the seismic profile can also be forward calculated on a test basis. In comparison with the measurement data, one can see that the characteristic properties of the observations can be well reproduced in the forward calculation. Afterwards, further processing steps in the time range are carried out, including frequency filtering and deconvolution. At the end, the profile is migrated in a depth profile using the velocity model. This depth migration clearly reveals the upper edge of the salt formation in this example. The flanks of the salt domes can be clearly seen. In this example, however, the base of the salt is fuzzy and not well resolved. Further analysis, such as three-dimensional inversions of the data, are necessary to obtain a complete picture of the deeper layers. If this is the case, the final interpretation with regard to oil and gas deposits can be conducted. In this video, you learned how to acquire and process data in marine seismics. Airgun sound sources and hydrophones are drawn on long streamers behind exploration vessels, and a large number of shots and measurements are conducted. The following data processing results in a structural image of the subsurface. The example of the southern North Sea has shown you how salt structures can provide information on the presence of oil and natural gas deposits. An iterative combination of stacking, velocity analysis, migration, and deconvolution leads ultimately to an interpretal image of the subsurface, revealing the locations of potential oil and gas deposits. Thank you.